Everybody, this is Teresa Swan and today I'm making a video about doTERRA lavender, which is absolutely beautiful. It's not like other lavender. I've tried over the years different lavenders for sleep and things and they smell like lavender, but unfortunately there's so many fakes out there and they can put just one drop of lavender in and the whole bottle can be called 100% pure oil. Which I suppose technically it might be, because it might be castor oil, it might be almond oil they've put in the bottle, but one drop of tiny drop of lavender, or they may even be adding other fillers in, like toxic chemical made up smells of lavender that might be in things like air fresheners, you see. So lavender, most people know that this is good for calming and for sleep, but of course if you use inferior lavenders they won't work. This I know is great for calming. I use this on my dog. I do actually put this neat on my dog, but other people may find, but I know a lot about the oils. I put them neat on myself, you know, so I know that I can do that to my dog, but other people shouldn't do that. They should dilute them. This is also great for spots. I have dabbed it onto individual spots and I've gave this to my son to do the same, and I encourage other people to do this. If you're going somewhere and there's one huge thing growing on your chin or your nose, put a dab of this on. You might have to do it a few times, but it will definitely start the healing process. It's also great for fever, you know, especially babies and children. You can rub this onto the bottom of their feet, it can dilute it, and this will bring instant calming, help them to sleep. It will help with all sorts of things like colic. It's one of those that is good for allergies, so you could inhale this up your nose or put just a little bit under your nose to help with allergies, and you can take it in capsules as well. Diluted and often with lemon and peppermint. It's good for hay fever and those sort of allergies. It's very good for boils, blisters, cuts. They do say that if you're in doubt, if you've got lots of oils, therapeutic ones of course, and you don't know which ones to use, it's either lavender or frankincense. And they all say frankincense is the king of oils, but this comes very close to me, because this can be used for so many different things. Most people just believe it is for sleep, don't they? I have found out recently when something bit me when I was hanging out my washing, so it's the ice cream van, that I was about to go off to somewhere to do a reading, and I thought, I can't sit there scratching because it's very distracting, isn't it? So I came in and I put straight away a dab of lavender onto my doTERRA lavender onto my very stingy, itchy foot that immediately started to itch. And by the time I left the house, it had gone. And that was only 5 minutes later, by the way. I was hanging the washing out and just going to go get my car and go. This is also very good for hyperactivity, so this will help to calm down hyperactive dogs. That's why I put it on my dog. And children, and yourself. You know, sometimes you're feeling very hyperactive and anxious. It's going to calm down those thoughts. It's very good for crying. You know, so if you're feeling very emotional, to put some on your pulse points or inhale from the bottom. It's very good to also, of course, put in diffusers, and that's a great way to get it into your body by inhaling it, and you don't even realise you are, you know. It's great for women going through the menopause. It's great for calming emotions when you're going through female cycles. It's very good for dry lips, for mood swings, for pain. You know, it's one of the things that you can use, like, that's why they say if in doubt, you don't know which to use. It's good to always carry a little bottle of this around in your bag, because any problem you come across, this would actually help it. It's amazing. It's very good for depression. It helps to lift people's moods, so it's not just calming, it helps to lift mood at the same time, which is amazing. It's a sedative. It can help with seizures. Dry skin. I've put it on dry skin, on my dog and me, and told my son to do this. I've also put it onto my hair when I've been sitting at events with my oils and I've been, you know, nothing's going on, and I just put a dab of lavender on my oil, or put a dab of lavender onto my finger, and I just, you know, go through my hair where it's really dry, and within minutes it doesn't feel dry anymore, and it's not like this is oily, this isn't oily, this soaks in. It's not, you know, this is how you know often that some oils are very fake, because they leave an oily patch on your skin, so that would tell you that it's one of those thick oils in there, such as castor oil, and that's why it's not absorbing so very easily, because This is just pure lavender oil, and it disappears. As soon as you put it onto you, it goes. It absorbs in. This is very good for rheumatoid arthritis. So I wish I'd had this when my mum was alive, because she, you know, could have really benefited from this. Both inhaling it to lift mood and to calm anxious thoughts, and worry thoughts, of course, and to also rub onto the skin, you know, the sore joints. It's very good for teeth grinding. So I have actually put this onto my face around the area of the top teeth and along my jawline and over my temples when I've been teeth, because I do that, I have done that. I haven't, don't do as much now, but I was doing it for years, teeth grinding. I broke quite a few of my teeth. And I did have a therapeutic one, but not doTERRA's. I was using Young's, and then I signed up to this company this year. So I've been using therapeutic oils for 4 years. You can take this internally, not cheap ones, of course, only these ones, and similar, you know, pronounced therapeutic oils. You can do that with. You can't do it with any oils. This is also very good for wrinkles, and I sometimes put it on my face, around my eyes, and on my forehead. It's very good for also for wounds, for worms, if you've got a worm problem. So you could probably treat, you could treat your dog with this. Diluted, of course, very diluted. It's very good for ticks. So that's something we can get, can't we? Sorry. And it's very good for ulcers. That could be skin ulcers. And if you trick it internally, it's also going to do some help to ulcers, but it's mainly the ones so on the skin. Very good for Parkinson's disease. For stress, for rashes, so baby or you or children have got rashes, itchy rashes, so good for itching, as I found out twice recently actually, so good for itching. So midges, gnats, it actually can help keep them away, so if you're going to bed and you seem to get bitten at night time, you'd only need one drop on perhaps each arm or one drop on two arms, you know, because it's so strong, so powerful that it can smell, so they would be put off. If they don't like you, they'd be put off by that, wouldn't they? It's very good for arthritis, as I said, and that's different types of arthritis. It's very good for post-labour and postpartum part of pregnancy, isn't it? Or is that pre-menopause, isn't it? All those things women-related, really. That's probably why so many women like lavender, you know, because it's well, most people like looking at it in the garden, don't they? The bees are always on lavender, so they know, as most people do, really trust bees. And if the lavender bushes are covered in bees, you know how wonderful that plant is, don't you? It's very good for stretch marks, and you know, just rubbing it on, you could mix it with some other oil to make it go further. So you could put that on stretch marks, and it will take some time, but they will definitely ease, you know, not be look so obvious. And of course, if you're pregnant and you put that on, that's helping the baby. And it's also helping your skin, isn't it? It's also very good for sunburn, as some people in my team have found out, because they got sunburn on holiday, must have fell asleep in the sun, and they put lavender on, and they didn't have any pain. So it proved to them that works. It's very good also for withdrawal. So if you're feeling that you're withdrawing from society, this could help to sort of lift your emotions and help you to think a bit differently and get out. It's also very good for gas, exhaustion, convulsions, as I said. Sorry, that is my dog barking, who keeps barking at the door. She's very sensitive and she hears people outside in the street, and she's not every day she starts barking, it's just this afternoon. You know, it's always if someone's near to the door or very close to the gate, you know, of the house. This is very good for dandruff. And like I said, it's good for about 100 different things. So to me, this is the superior oil, isn't it? This is it, as they say, if in doubt, use this. It has been in the past used for typhoid and whooping cough, you know, because it will cut, you can rub it on your throat, it will calm down agitation, you know, on your chest, on your throat. It has been used by people to lower blood pressure in the past, in medieval times. Well, if they used it, why? It must still apply now, hasn't it? Herpes, it's a bit of a good for indigestion, like I said, dandruff, insomnia, lymphatic system drainage, and menopausal systems. your lymphatic system. You could rub it, you know, under your arms where your lymph nodes are, and look up on the internet where all the other lymph nodes are, or get a chart. Lavender is an analgesic, an antiseptic, an anticonvulsion, an antidepressant, antifungal, antihistamine, anti-inflammatory. That's why it's good for, you know, swollen joints, those sort of things. Antispasmodic, antitoxic, sedative, regenerative. You know, it's a little bottle of wonder, isn't it? And that's why I love it, and that's why there's hardly any left. And I've not had this long. I have been giving samples away to people as well. But I do rub it on the bottom of my feet some nights. At the moment I'm going through a process of rubbing a different oil on my feet as I go to sleep for 2 nights, and then I change the bottle and then use another bottle. Because while you're asleep, it's doing something to your body, isn't it? It's healing something in your body. And then I usually rub, unless it's just one drop, I rub that one drop on one foot, one drop on the other foot, and then on the same finger, I then rub that on my around my throat, and as I always, I'm breathing that in while I'm asleep. Because one drop, two drops, really goes a long way. This is also very good for psoriasis, so any itching, inflamed skin, this is a little bottle of magic and wonder, you know? There's so many, and not toxic, of course, because all the things we use from the chemist and the doctors, generally, most of them are toxic, aren't they? And not good for our skin. You can just look up the ingredients on the internet, you can find them. Well, thank you all for listening, and if you fancy trying doTERRA lavender, which, like I said, is not like the cheap lavenders. So a lot of people I hear say, well, I've used lavender, that didn't work, that didn't do that. No, because you're not using therapeutic grade lavender. You have to use the top quality ones to get the benefit of that plant, not something that's been highly diluted or may even not have any true lavender in at all. Well, thank you all for listening. Bye bye.